In this video, I'll show you how I solved a fairly common problem with microwave ovens where it runs a couple of seconds and then shuts off. Now this is an over-the-range whirlpool. We love it. But when I hit my favorite button, the 30-second button, that's what happens. Not a good sign. Let's try that one more time. I know what you're thinking. Just replace the microwave, right? Well, we like this one, and before I disconnect it from this vent, pull my range out, unhang it from the wall, load it into the car, and bring it to the landfill, I'm gonna rule a few things out. The owner's manual was not useful for that. It did not describe anything like what we were seeing. Microwaves can be a little complex. If you're not comfortable with this, maybe you should let the repair guy do it. But the good news is they've been around for 60 years, and we've learned some of the common problems with microwaves. And one of them is, the door interlock switches. They're designed for safety to make sure there's no way this thing is going to turn on while the door is open. If they're not working in sync, you're out of luck. Main power relays carry a lot of current. They can be easily replaced, and we'll show you how to take a look at those. Main power fuse is probably not the issue in this case, but we're going to show you how to rule that out. And then the main power control boards, they're exposed to a lot of heat. Sometimes components can come loose. Now, what we need to do is remove this vent cover. A couple of screws, once we get it out of the way, we've got access to another single screw. First thing to do is unplug it. I hope you weren't going to work on this with it plugged in. Pull the vent cover off. So now we can remove the single screw that holds the control panel on. And it slides up and away. And once you pull it away, you've got a little hanger on the bottom you have to slide out. Got a service sheet tucked in here. We'll take a look at that. You've got a main fuse. First thing I'm going to do is disconnect the wires from the main power relay. Let's take a look at this service sheet they've got in here for us. Now there's three failure codes listed in here. We didn't see any failure codes on the display, but they do talk about the main power relay a little bit, so I have a feeling it may be a possible culprit. This is what it looks like, this big black box here. I've disconnected the wires from it. Now the rest of these wires, they've got little thumb releases, and they're all different. So don't be too intimidated by this. When it comes time to put it together, again, they're all different. You can't get it wrong. So we'll need to unscrew the main ground wire here. Now this is where the door latches interact with the interlock switches. And to get to those, we're gonna have to remove this panel. It's just two screws. And I can't get my head in there, but I can get a camera in there to give you guys some good footage of those switches. These are the interlock switches. The top one, you've got two switches on the mount, and then the one down below, it's just got a single switch on there. When we test these, you want to test them in place, and you want to make sure that the mounts are healthy. They're made out of plastic. They often fail. You can see everything working now in sync, but to make sure the switches are also working, we're going to test them in place. You can see these mounts have a lot of plastic in them that can break. Two of the switches look like this. They've just got two tabs that have to be tested. One of them is actually a dual switch. It's got three tabs. We have to test it twice against the common and upper tab and then the lower tab. To do it, you use a standard multimeter. Instead of voltage, we're going to move it down to resistance. Disconnected is a one, connected is a zero. And we're going to start with that top switch that's got three tabs. We're connected to the first two tabs on it. You can see that it's connected, and when we open the door, it disconnects. So it's working fine. Now we're connected to the second tab, test two. Okay, the door is closed, it's disconnected. Open it and it connects. So it's working well. Now we're gonna do the other top switch. It's only got two tabs. So when the door is closed, disconnected, open, it connects. Finally, we're gonna do the bottom switch. Also only has two tabs. And when the door is closed, it's connected, open the door, it disconnects. So that's all working well. And because we tested it in place, we know the complete interlock system is working. And if one of yours is broken, these screws on the front are how you remove the mounts, and you can buy the mounts with or without the switches on board. Just use the model number of your oven to make sure you get the right ones. Now we can put the panel back, check the main fuse. Now we're going to use the same settings on the meter to check this. So a bad fuse would be a one, and a good fuse would be a zero. So we have got a good fuse, so we can put that back in place. Next, we're gonna have to separate the control board from the button pad. And to do that, just lift up this latch on the connector, slide out the ribbon cable that connects to the button pad, and put the latch back down. And now we can remove the six screws that hold the control board into the housing. And once we get those screws out, we can lift it up and inspect some of the connections that are on the back, because those are often the culprit. So you can see all these little solders. Well, sometimes they come loose. There's the main relay. These two on the left look burnt, but they still look okay. But you can see this one's lost its connection. Glad I found it. That's definitely our problem, guys. So we're gonna go ahead and re-solder that. You can see all the burn marks. These things are, they get a lot of abuse, a lot of heat exposure, a lot of current going through that relay. Also sits above cooking food every day. So these display windows should be cleaned up as well. To re-solder, you could use a standard little iron like this. It will work, it's fine. I have a heavier duty gun that I prefer and some rosin core solder that I like to use. And you can see these three tabs. I've now removed all the solder. So actually you can remove this relay. I can show it to you. You can use the numbers if you need to order new ones. I found them easily available on the internet. Now I'm gonna go ahead and re-solder these. I'm gonna put fresh connections on here. Don't overdo it. That's it. We've got a fix. I'm gonna show you what these look like. These connections are very good and they're now ready for more years of heat and door slamming. So now what we're gonna do is clean up these display windows. Look at that, just a quick wipe and we got all that junk off of there. So sitting above cooking food every day definitely deposits a lot on these displays. So this should clear things up nicely for reading the clock. Okay, so now we're gonna reconnect that ribbon cable. So lift up the latch again like we did removing it, slide it all the way in until it stops and lock it down. Now we can put the six screws back in, and I'm definitely fast forwarding through this to save you guys a little bit of time. Now, I want to show you these mounting tabs on the side. These lock tabs, they're plastic. When I removed it, one of them was pretty much broken off. So you can see I've reinforced it with epoxy, and you guessed it. In this case, I used JB Weld. Did the same for the vent cover. The holes were shattered, so I just embedded a washer and some JB Weld, let it sit overnight. Very strong, and you do not see it when the thing's mounted. So it was a good fix. Now we're going to attach the ground cable. And again, attaching all these cables, they're all different. Just make sure you get the black on top of the brown or however you found your power relay. The rest of these, they're all different. You can't get them wrong. So just make sure though that you push them all the way in until they snap. They all have lock mechanisms. And once you get those into place, then we're ready to put the bottom latch in place and put our service sheet back. Now these side mounts, you push it in and let it slide down to lock. And then we can put in the single mount screw. Plug it back into the power. Set the clock. Put the vent cover back on. And now we're ready for a quick test. 30 seconds. I'm going to speed through some of this. And it looks like we have success. There's steam coming off of there, so this was a good repair. Well, if this helped you guys out, please do give a thumbs up and subscribe for future videos. And to help out anybody else trying to fix this problem, please do share this video. Thanks for watching.